It is an absolute pleasure to have you here with us at Raindance. What does it mean for you to be a part of this beautiful celebration of independent cinema?
It really is one. It really is one. Raindance is such an incredible place. I mean, it's been, especially this year and the 30-year anniversary, which this is, we were really thinking for a long time, where would we be happy to be showing this movie and premiering it internationally? And when we heard about Raindance wanting us, we were like, yes, because we made this movie for it. It is the most independent movie you could even imagine. For me, for real, but I think for anybody that will see it and know the way that we've made it as well. So we're really happy to be here. I mean, Connie Converse was someone that was really important for us. She was a singer-songwriter who was just such a misfit, and she couldn't figure out how to do this, how to be the part of society. I mean, it's really hard for even me to still figure this out. I mean, these red carpets, these lights on your face, it's something that for a lot of people is very hard. And so what she did is she packed all her stuff in her car, and she disappeared. And she was never heard from since. And that secret time she had on the road, the time that was never recorded, that was only hers, that possibly didn't even end in a suicide. Possibly she's still living somewhere secretly. It was something that, to us filmmakers, was so inspiring. And I guess that's what we wanted to capture. We didn't want to make a verbatim biopic of Connie. We wanted to make a story of a secret time that she had alone on the road.
On that secret time, your character is uncovering who this man Gregory is and gradually becoming more enamored with the idea of him. Can you talk a little bit about that process and what makes the amazing John such a perfect fit for that character?
The amazing John is a perfect fit for any character because he's just the most phenomenal actor there is. But, you know, he made a movie called Me and You and Everyone We Know with Miranda July, who I love so dearly. And in that movie, he was very delicate and soft, which is not always the way he plays such different types of characters. He, in Winter's Bone, he's such a, you know, scary man, and his character is called Teardrop, and you know, he's just very intense. And we thought that there's so much delicacy and mysticism and magic to him as a person and as an actor, and we really wanted Gregory Milloy to have that secret side. At the same time, he has this very, I mean, I wouldn't say what kind of side, but Gregory Milloy, which is the John Hawkes character, is all of this.
Can you talk about the unique challenges and rewards of a road film, making a film that literally takes place in different locations and in the car?
A lot in the car. I mean, sitting in the car for so long was very hard on my butt. But also, you know, I spent a lot of time preparing for this. Maybe if I was a better actor, I wouldn't have to do it, but because I may not be that good yet, I just lived in the car alone in the desert for a while preparing to it. So really the time that I had spent on the road and in a car was really long. I mean, it was almost a few months of doing that. And you know, the road brings a lot of gifts to you. There's a lot of incredible people and magic that you can't even imagine that will come to you. But at the same time, you're very, very closed off, and that can also be quite, you know, scary at the same time.
And just finally, we're here at a festival that above all celebrates the power of storytelling. I'm curious what it means for you to be a storyteller and why telling stories matters so much.
Everything is stories. Life is short, but stories are long, and art will live forever. And the only thing we have as human beings are the stories we tell. I mean, we're all going to be gone really soon. And if there are some stories that we can leave behind, it's the only thing we humans have, really.